Oh, I'm Norma Cassidy. You were just grand.
Thank you.
Oh, and this is King Marchand.
How do you do?
How do you do?
I gotta admit, for a while there, I was really cheesed off. King's tongue was hanging out a foot. Then, you know, when you took that wig off, I just couldn't believe it. King still doesn't.
I'm flattered.
I'm delighted you could make it, Mr. Marchand.
Oh, thank you.
May I introduce Mr. Todd? It's a pleasure.
This is Miss Cassidy.
Observe.
Enchanted.
Oh, me too.
Well, what do you think of our new star?
He thinks he's a phony.
Oh, I think she's very talented.
But he doesn't think you're a man.
I'll tell her what I think.
Her, you see?
Norma, mingle.
Oh, sure. Care to mingle with me, Mr. Todd?
Miss Cassidy, excluding Victor's performance, mingling with you may well turn out to be the highlight of the evening.
I just love Frenchmen.
Oh, so do I.
I'll get you a drink.
Well, thank you.
You were saying, Mr. Marchand.
Well, I just find it hard to believe that you're a man.
Because you found me attractive as a woman?
Yes, as a matter of fact.
It happens frequently.
Not to me.
It just proves the old adage, there's a first time for everything.
I don't think so.
But you're not 100% sure.
Practically.
Ah, but to a man like you, someone who believes he could never, under any circumstances, find another man attractive, the margin between practically and for sure must be as wide as the Grand Canyon.
If you were a man, I'd knock your block off.
And prove that you're a man.
That's a woman's argument.
Your problem, Mr. Marchand, is that you're preoccupied with stereotypes. I think it's as simple as you're one kind of man, I'm another.
And what kind are you?
One that doesn't have to prove it. To myself or anyone. Excuse me.